In this video, I will try to explain what is the reason behind the tides in the ocean and the underlying physics of it. Before coming to the main topic, let's understand some of the basic things, like Newton's gravitational law. According to this law, everything in the universe attracts every other thing in the universe, and the strength of this force depends on the distance between them. Shorter the distance, stronger will be the force. For example, Sun attracts the Earth and Earth attracts the Sun towards each other along the line joining their centers. So now let's understand another thing, that is space-time. Space-time is like a fabric in which all the things in the universe exist. And it sounds to be obvious also, because if there is something which exists, then it must exist somewhere. Means it lies in space. And yes, that thing also exists in some time interval also. Means it also lies in time. So now every object in the universe moves in space-time. This space-time can be wrapped or distorted by the massive objects. Like black holes distort the space-time to its extreme level. Sun, Earth and Moon also distort the space-time. As I said, every object moves in space-time, and the important thing is that they move in straight line unless there is some force act on it. Earth also moves in straight line in space-time. The path on which object will move is dictated by space-time geometry. Suppose space-time is flat. The path of object will be straight line on this flat space-time. And if space-time is curved, then the straight path is also curved. Earth moves in elliptical orbit around the Sun. But that path is a straight line in space-time. Now you can argue that why the Earth moves in straight line even when there is external gravitational force acting on it. Actually, the gravitational force is nothing but the curved space-time itself is gravitational field which produces the gravitational force effect. So where the space-time is curved, there is effect of gravitational force. This is from the general theory of relativity given by Albert Einstein in 1915. So now let's understand something more. Consider a flat space-time. If two objects starts moving along two parallel paths, then they will move forever parallel to each other. Because as I said earlier that objects move in straight line in space-time unless some force act on them. So now consider wrapped space-time about some massive object. It could be a black hole. These blue lines starts parallel to each other and then headed into black hole. These paths try to remain parallel to each other, but they get attracted to each other due to underlying geometry of space-time. Similarly, take those green path. Traveling along the circumference around the black hole, these green lines also started parallel to each other, but then these lines get more separated due to underlying space-time. Another way of thinking is that it seems like there are some forces due to which some paths get attracted to each other and some get more separated. These force lines are called 10x lines by the famous physicist Kip S. Thorne, who was awarded the 2017 Nobel Prize in Physics for his work at LIGO and the first direct detection of gravitational waves. So these red and white lines are called 10x lines around the black holes. These red 10x lines stretches those green paths which started parallel to each other and then they get separated. And these white 10x lines squeezed those blue lines which started as parallel paths but then headed into the black hole. This stretching and squeezing is just a different way of thinking about the influence of wrapping of space-time. Black holes are not the only object that produces stretching and squeezing forces. Stars, planets and moons also produces them. Now we start our main topic. What's the reason behind the tides? Newton gave his argument on the basis of his gravitational theory. There is an attractive force between Earth and Moon, means that Earth attracts the Moon and Moon attracts the Earth. And as we know, there is a cover of sea on the surface of Earth. So let's consider three points, A, B and C. From the Newton's gravitational law, farther the distance, lower will be the force. Therefore, the force on point A will stretch the ocean and there will be a high tide. Then force on point B attracts the Earth towards the Moon, which results into the stretching of ocean on the far side of the earth also. Now, the force on point C is less as compared to force at point A and B, because point C is farthest one. So there is two high tides, and on the lateral sides of earth, ocean gets squeezed. So there are two low tides also. This was Newton's explanation of ocean tides. The sun's tidal gravity also contributes to the tides. Its stretch and squeeze get added to the moon's stretch and squeeze. In the relativistic description of the moon's tides, the tidal forces are produced by the blue tendex lines that squeeze the earth's lateral side and red tendex lines that stretches towards and away from the moon. This is just like a black hole's tendex lines as we discussed before. The moon's tendex lines represent the moon's wrapping of space and time. It is remarkable that a so tiny wrapping of space-time can produce big enough forces to cause the ocean tides. So this is the end of this video. I hope you get something new out of this video. So thanks for watching this video. If you like it, then subscribe this channel and share this video.